As most of you know, I like to stay in touch with young makers around the world and support them when I can. Lydia is a young maker in America, and just like me, she's learning CNC. But honestly, I think she's already ahead of me.
But I also did some modifications to the actual box, the enclosure it is in. I think it looks great, and I hope you guys like the time lapses. They might be a little long, but I hope you enjoy them. So I'll see you guys in a little bit.
That enclosure looks like a really good idea. Last time I used my Gemisu CNC engraver, it made a lot of noise and a big mess. So today I'm going to follow Lydia's suggestion and build my own enclosure with some leftover aluminum extrusion I have. Before I do, please take a minute and subscribe to Lydia's channel and show your support. If you are tired of foolish reaction and prank videos and want to encourage kids to be better, we have to back it up. Make sure that the kid in the class with the most followers is the kid with the tech channel. Now, time to get to work. I'm using Tinkercad to decide the panels for the size of the enclosure. It's not technically the best CAD tool for the job, but it's the one I know best, and it works well enough. I just have to export the files as an SVG. This is a new laser cutting program I'm using. It's called Lightburn. It's so much better than LaserCAD, which is what I used to use. Honestly, with this new software, it's like having a laser cutter that costs twice as much. It gives you so many more features. I'm just going to give you a quick note now. Another time, I'll do a full tutorial. It's really worth every penny. I'll put a link in the description box. Okay, I'll import the SVG file. It does not quite fit on the workbench, so I'm going to rotate it. Now, I'll just adjust the power and send it to the laser cutter. Oh shit! it? I think that was the wrong setting. Fortunately, I got my fire extinguisher. That's quite scary. The holes are a little bit messy. I think it's the settings, but I'm going to fix that. Okay, I'm going to mark this first and then make some holes. I don't remember which YouTube channel I learned from, but this should keep everything lined up. This is Tinkercad again. I'm making adapters for the vacuum hose. The printed part that goes on the cutting head to suck up the dust, I already downloaded from Thingiverse. This is a model slicer. I'm using Simplify 3D here. It prepares the CAD model for printing, lets you choose the material, resolution, all that. This video is sponsored by Creality 3D. I recommend either the Ender Free or the CR10S Prong shown here. Both are low-cost, reliable 3D printers that I use almost daily for everything from household repairs to my DIY projects. Check the link in the description box. I decided to use soft vinyl for the corners. It's a lot easier than trying to heat bend the acrylic, and it will keep the dust in. I guess it won't do much for the noise, but we'll have to see. I'm using soft magnetic strips to keep the door panel in place. Let's take a look. I've got the dust removal hose going around the back, and now that 3D printed port on the side. Below that is the hole for the control and power wires. The hose goes to a 3D printing adapter on the side that fits the handle to my vacuum. I decided to use free rubber feet, so I don't have to worry about leveling it. And most of the CNC machine's weight is in the back anyway. The magnetic cover worked really well. I think I will use that design in the future. It leaves lots of rooms to access the CNC machine, and I don't have to fiddle about with designing for finicky hinges and latches. I designed this more for dust than for noise. I think I would need double wall construction and some foam to deal with noise. This is fine for now. I don't plan on any very long cutting jobs. I hope you're enjoying watching my very slow learning process with this. If you are, please subscribe to my channel. It makes it easier to get review units and really, really helps. That's it for today. I'll see you all next time. And remember, if I can do it, anyone can do it.